let us discuss about the energy stored in a parallel plate capacitor. In the previous section, we have discussed about the charging of a parallel plate capacitor in which, say, we are given with a parallel plate capacitor of capacitance C with plate separation D and each plate area is equals to A. If the capacitor is connected across a battery of constant potential difference V, we have studied that on closing the circuit to maintain the same potential difference across the capacitor, the positive terminal of battery will pull free electrons of the left plate and displaces these free electrons to the right plate of the capacitor, due to which the left side plate will get positively charged and right side plate will get negatively charged. And after complete charging of the capacitor, which we term as a steady state, the final charge on the capacitor is equals to CV. And in this situation, we can state that there exists an electric field, a uniform electric field from one plate to another. And we can write electric field between plates, which is established due to charging, is equals to V by D. Now, in this situation, before charging of capacitor, there was no electric field. That means there was no field energy in existence between the plates. But after complete charging, there exists an electric field E. And we already studied in the previous topic that whenever there exists an electric field E, there also exists an electrostatic field energy in the region, of which the energy density we can write as field energy density. We already studied that is given as half epsilon naught E square. So finally, after complete charging, there exists some electrostatic field energy in the region. And we can directly write total energy stored between plates of capacitor is this can be written as U, that is half epsilon naught E square is the energy density which is measured in joule per meter cube, and we multiply it with the volume of region in which the electric field exists, that is AD. A is the area of plate and D is the separation. That is the volume in which this electric field exists. Now we substitute the value of electric field here, it is half epsilon naught V by D square multiplied by AD, and here you can see 1D gets cancelled out, and epsilon naught A by D we can write as capacitance of capacitor. This we know that the value of capacitance is related to area and plate separation as epsilon naught A by D. So here we can substitute the value, the total energy stored between the plates of this parallel plate capacitor when it is charged to a potential difference V is written as half epsilon naught A by D, we can write as C multiplied by V square. This is quite an important term you should always keep in mind. And we can also transform it in terms of charge, like if charge on the plates are plus Q and minus Q, that we know that final charge on the plates will be CV. So here we can write V is equals to Q by C from this expression, and if you substitute 1 C gets cancelled out and the relation can be written as Q square by 2 C. Or if 1 CV can be written as Q, it can also be written as half of QV. These are also the relations which are equally useful. But primarily in majority of problems, we are going to use these two relations, which are used based on whatever information is given in the problem. Like if potential difference is given, we use half CV square as energy of capacitor, and if charge on the plate of capacitor is given, we use Q square by 2C as energy of capacitor.